a story that I'm going to be reading. It's going to be in English for the English guests. It's called Backyard Tragedy. Once upon a time, in the damp, dark soil underneath Cardiff Castle, a slender slug called Sullyan shed slimy tears. "Sullyan," said his lover Lennon, "why art thou crying?" His strong, stripy torso slipped through the moist earth towards his sad friend. "It is for thee that I cry," replied Sullyan. "My internal organs are twisting with desire to bear you a child. But how can we rear a baby slug under these conditions?" "Thou art right," said Llewellyn, quickly retracting his tentacles at this revelation. "It is raining so much, and there are hardly any fresh leaves or vegetables around. We end up getting wasted every night. This is only summer. Autumn is going to be, it's going to be much worse. Oh, much as I am attracted to you, Sullyan, it would be irresponsible to occur on private parts together with a view of laying eggs." "Oh, Llewellyn, I wish I could control my feelings as well as thou can contain thine," said Sullyan, sliding his slim mantle towards his large, muscular friend. "Hold off," said Llewellyn. "What part of no don't thou understand?" "Oh, it is the rain," sniffed Sullyan. "I love thee dearly, and I do respect thy opinion, but I've had a bit too much to drink." Llewellyn curled his bulging body and pushed against the black, rain-soaked soil to get away from his broody buddy. But, despite his stout constitution, he couldn't escape Sullyan, who was more flexible and fueled with desire. "Why don't we leave the castle and find ourselves a nice garden?" Sullyan asked his fleeing friend. "I hear vegetable growing is very popular these days." "But I love the castle," replied Llewellyn. "I enjoy getting drunk every night, and all my comrades live here. We can have homegrown cabbage and lettuce." Sullyan's sensory tentacles tickled his mate's tail. "Is it not thy dream to sandwich an immature tomato plant with me?" "Oh, I do love thee, Sullyan, but then let us get out of here." "Well, that's what I'm trying to do." Llewellyn was panting already. "Promise not to touch me until we find a good home for our children, and then I shall give thee all the offspring thou want." That night, when the heavenly shower was left on again, two slimy silhouettes crawled along the curbs of Cardiff. A stringy, stress-shaped first, with a slim, sensual shadow following its slime trail. "Those slugs aren't exactly known for their speed. They soon reached my back garden." Llewellyn mounted the first pepper plant and hoped that Sullyan would forget about their reproduction plans for the night now that they had found such an abundance of food. Alas, Sullyan had no eye for the green leaves, and he only climbed the thin stem to relish his friend. When Llewellyn reached the top of the plant, he realized there was nowhere to go. He bit down hard in the green leaves, and when he felt Sullyan's silky shlong stroke his puny stone, he knew that he would never be able to enjoy the taste of pepper plant again. It seemed to take all night long, and when Sullyan was finally done, it started to get light already. Llewellyn tried to seek shelter under an old handbag that I'd left there. But Sullyan still wouldn't leave him alone. "Can I have some space, please?" Llewellyn begged. I can't sleep like this." "Oh no, I'm not done with thee yet," said Sullyan. "I've given thee mine, but thou haven't given me thine yet. We are hermaphrodites after all." That morning, I was shocked to see that my plants had been abused. I made Freddy, my boyfriend, an omelette for breakfast, and I crushed the egg eggshells and spread them around the plants so that the slugs couldn't reach them anymore. "We're in serious trouble now," said Lemon. "A few days from now, I'll be giving birth to 30 little eggs. I'm starving already, and now we can't even reach the fresh vegetables anymore."
"Don't worry, my love," said Sunny.
"We shall go to the neighbours. I'm sure there will be plenty of food there. Follow me, big one." Poor Lemon felt that he had no choice, and he followed the slender slug that had impregnated him. "Come on, Slowpoke," shouted Sunny over his mantle. He had reached an opening in the wall to the next garden already, and he poked his head through. "I think they even have a lawn and flowers. Paradise is this way." When Lemon finally reached the hole in the wall, half an hour later, all he saw was Sunny's shiny body at the end of the tunnel. "What's wrong?" he asked. "I cannot move," moaned Sunny. "I was so hungry after yesterday's activity. I just took a bite of the first thing I saw. It must have been poisoned. I knew it smelled suspicious, but I was so hungry. I think I'm paralyzed." Startled, Lemon began to crawl backwards.
"Don't leave me here," shouted Sunny. "It's thy fault in the first place. Thou made me do all the hard work and didn't leave any of that pepper plant for me, you greedy cow."
But he could feel the sun on his mantle already. Lemon crossed the garden as quickly as he could, avoiding the sight of the scrubby pepper plant. He heard Sunny sing a good deal of further insults at him, and he didn't want to be there at noon when the sun would start to blister his paralyzed back. Lemon wanted to go back to the castle, but he was heavy with pregnancy and grief. Though it had taken the slugs no more than 1 night to reach my garden 2 days later, Lemon still hadn't reached his home. He was hungry and thirsty, leaned against a courgette plant to catch his breath, when suddenly he smelled something that made all of his glands ooze with delight. It was a slightly bitter, refreshing smell. It was so good that a mere whiff of it made him forget his sorrow. The saucer of ale attracted the pregnant, dehydrated smug like a magnet. Lemon had no say in the matter, and he didn't even know what was happening to him when he slid headfirst into the liquid gourd. He absorbed it like a sponge, drank more than he'd ever drunk before, poisoning his parasitic eggs with alcohol. The next day, a woman with marigold gloves fished Lemon's inflated corpse out of the saucer and chucked him in the dustbin. The other slugs at the castle thought that Lemon and Sunny never returned because they had found themselves a lush garden and started a happy family.